Hey, curious minds. Today we're diving into one of the biggest, or should I say tiniest, questions in physics. Is everything infinitely divisible, or is there a fundamental limit to how small things can get? For most of human history, people believed that you could keep chopping things up indefinitely. But then the ancient Greeks came along. Democritus, who was basically the first atomic theorist long before science was a thing, said, "Nope. There's the smallest piece of everything, and I'm calling it an atom." Of course, modern science proved him only half right. Atoms can be split into smaller particles. And then came quantum physics, which said, wait, we're not done yet. Scientists discovered quarks, which make up protons and neutrons, and leptons, which include electrons and neutrinos. So naturally, the big question became, can we go even smaller? Here's where things get weird. Despite all our smashing, crashing, and colliding of particles in giant particle accelerators, we haven't found anything smaller than quarks and electrons, and some scientists think we might never. Why? The standard model of particle physics. The highly successful theory suggests that quarks, electrons, and neutrinos are fundamental. They're not made of anything smaller. So far, the Planck length is considered to be the smallest ruler in our universe. A mind-bogglingly tiny distance of 10 to the negative 35th power meters. Below this scale, our current laws of physics completely break down. Gravity, quantum mechanics, and space-time itself start acting like a chaotic soup of uncertainty. Does anything even exist below the Planck length? Perhaps another universe isolated from ours. If something exists at this scale, it wouldn't affect our universe in any way we could observe, or it doesn't exist in a meaningful way. That means our universe might have a built-in, smallest possible size, a pixelated reality, if you will. Kind of like how video games look smooth until you zoom in too far and see the individual pixels. Maybe reality works the same way. Likewise, our observable universe could be one pixel of a universe in another dimension. So, is infinite division just a math fantasy? Many physicists believe infinity is a great mathematical tool, but not a physical reality. Why? Because whenever infinities show up in physics equations, they tend to cause problems. Think black holes, singularities, and quantum field theories that need renormalization to remove pesky infinities. However, science never sleeps. If new discoveries show our universe is smaller building blocks, well, then we'll just have to make another video. Stay curious, and don't try breaking things into infinity at home. Thank you for watching.